Hi everyone. I am very happy to welcome you all to Dr. JJ's Virtual Academy of Commerce. In this video, I am going to deliver a lecture on the topics meaning and definition of standard cost and standard costing, followed by steps involved in standard costing. These are all a couple of details related to my career. After you watch the full video, if you find the video beneficial to you, give a like to the video. Kindly do subscribe my channel and enable the notification so that you will get the notifications of my new videos related to the subjects marketing, accounting and financial management. Now let me start with the introduction of the topic. Standard costing is a very important system of cost control. Obviously, among the cost control techniques available in management accounting, standard costing is the foremost important tool available in front of the business concerns to effectively carry out cost control. It is important to determine what a product should cost, and if the actual cost is more than the determined cost, then why is it so? What are the reasons contributing for the differences between the actual cost and standard cost? How to correct such deviations and accommodate the actual cost within the predetermined standard cost? This is what really to be done with the support of the technique named standard costing. Standard costing aims at eliminating the wastage, and it also contributes for increase in efficiency in performances of the personnel through setting up standards for production expenses and production performances as well. A standard costing system can provide many useful information which cannot be given by actual or absorption cost systems. A standard cost system really eliminates the effects of job cost of fluctuations in volumes of output by separating the cost of idle facilities, because standard cost is nothing but the normal cost of producing something or carrying out an activity for utilizing the normal production efficiency at the normal level of output. Now let us get into the meaning of the concept titled standard cost. Standard cost is a predetermined cost. It is a determination in advance of production of what should be the cost of making something. It could be a product or it could be a service. When standard costs are used for the purposes of cost control, the technique is known as standard costing. So, we could understand the meaning of standard cost as it is a cost which is predetermined before a concern gets into the actual performance of the activities or actual performance over its activities. It determines the cost of each element of the activities. What is the cost supposed to be for each element of the activity to be performed is predetermined. Utilizing such standard costs which are predetermined for the purpose of controlling cost is nothing but the technique named standard costing. Now let us get into the definition given by Eric L. Kochler for the concept standard cost. According to him, standard cost is a forecast or predetermination of what actual cost should be under projected conditions, serving as a control and as a measure of production efficiency, or standard of comparison when ultimately aligned against actual cost. It furnishes a medium by which the effectiveness of current result can be measured and responsibility for deviations can be placed. So on the whole, we could understand the meaning of what is said by Eric L. Kochler through his definition for the concept of standard cost is that standard cost is a predetermined cost of what is going to be incurred in the name of cost under projected conditions for producing something. It also serves as a control mechanism and eventually contributes for improving efficiency of the performances of the personnel. It facilitates effective comparison of the standard with that of the actual of given activities which are measured. Therefore, the technique of standard cost comprises of the following. 1. It is a predetermined calculation of what cost ought to be under specific working conditions in relation to a given activity. Number two, it is built up by correlating standard quantity of machine time, labor time and material and forecasting future market trend for price standards. That's nothing but price for material, wage rates and machine cost per hour, etc. So it builds up by correlating the standard quantity of the input involved in offering a particular activity or in producing a particular activity. It could be of manufacturing a product or offering a service. The third point which we could derive from the definition given by Kochler for the concept standard cost is nothing but it provides basis for control through variance accounting. Unless standards are set for producing something or offering something, it is not possible to carry out control of the performances based on the comparison of actual cost with that of the standard set for such activities. The fourth point we could derive from the definition is nothing but it provides basis for valuation of stock and work in progress, and in some cases it also facilitates fixing selling price of the products and services. Let us get into the meaning of standard costing. Standard costing is a preparation of standard costs and applying them to measure the variations from the actual cost of a given activity. It analyzes the causes of variations with a view to maintain maximum efficiency in production. So obviously we could understand the fact that standard costing involves in determination of cost before a particular activity is carried out. After determining the cost, it involves in measuring the actual performance in terms of cost, and the actual cost could be measured with that of standard to identify and understand the causes for variations between the actual cost measured and the standard cost set for a given activity. The technique of standard costing may comprise of the following. 1. Ascertaining of standard cost under each element of cost like material, labor and overhead. We have separate set of variances with regard to material, labor and overhead in this topic. Number 2. Measurement of actual cost after the standards are set for all these activities in relation to material, labor and overhead, which are inputs for offering something, the actual cost incurred to offer the same thing are measured. The third one is nothing but comparison of actual cost with that of standard to find out the deviations or the causes for the deviations of the actual cost from that of the standard cost. And the fourth point is nothing but analysis of variances for the purpose of ascertainment of reasons of variances for taking appropriate actions wherever necessary so that maximum efficiency may be achieved in all the activities for which the standard costing technique is applied. Now let's get into the definition given by the Institute of Cost and Work Accountants of England for the concept of standard costing. It defines standard costing as the preparation and use of standard cost, their comparison with the actual cost and the analysis of variance to their causes and points of incidence. So it involves primarily three activities. 1. Determination of standard cost before the actual activity is carried out. Number 2. After the actual activity is carried out, the cost involved in offering or carrying out such activity is measured. That is what actual cost. And followed by the third activity which is carried out in the name of standard costing is nothing but analyzing and understanding the causes for the variances between the actual cost comparing that of the standard cost. Steps involved in standard costing is the next topic. The standard cost is divided into standards for materials, labor and overheads, as I already said. The subdivision of standards will be more useful for cost control purposes. The actual cost is recorded whenever they are incurred. The standard cost is compared to that of actual cost on various elements of the activities. The difference between the two costs is known as variance. For example, if the concern has decided to spend 1,000 rupees to offer a particular service, the 1,000 rupees is nothing but the standard cost of offering the service. Now, after determining the standard cost of 1,000 rupees for a given activity, the activity is carried out actually, followed by the actual cost of offering the activity is measured. If the actual cost of offering the same activity is exactly of 1,000 rupees, you can very well come to know the fact that the actual performance is on par with that of standard. If the actual cost is more than 1,000 rupees to offer the same activity, you can find there is an adverse situation. The cost which is spent over and above the predetermined standard cost is a negative one, which really pulls down the performance of the organization, or eventually it contributes for poor performance of the personnel in terms of their efficiency. This could very well be understood, and control mechanism could be carried out to correct such deviations and make sure that the actual cost is accommodated within the predetermined standard cost of producing or offering the activity, which could be production of a product or offering of a service. The variances are calculated element wise. As I said, with regard to materials, you can have material variances in the name of material cost variance, material price variance, material quantity variance, material mix variance, and material yield variance as well. The similar classifications we could find under the head of labor and overhead. The management of a given organization which practices or makes use of standard costing technique can take corrective measures to set the things right in the days to come. The standard costing involves the following steps. 1. Determination of standard cost. 2. Recording of actual cost. 3. Comparison of the standard cost with that of the actual cost. 4. Finding out the causes for variance. And 5. Reporting of the variance to the management so that the management could find out the inefficiency of the personnel involved and take necessary corrective measures so that this particular problem could be avoided in the days to come. What is the conclusion? The standard cost will be of no use if they are not compared with that of actual cost. Unless you set the standard cost, you cannot really involve in measuring the actual cost, and the same could be compared with that of standard cost. So therefore, determination of the standard cost is essential, and at the same time, measuring the actual cost is also essential so that you come out with the concluding activity of comparing the actual cost with that of standard to measure the level of efficiency of the personnel involved in offering the particular activity. The basic purpose of standard costing is to determine the efficiency or inefficiency in manufacturing a particular product or offering a particular service. This will be possible only if both standard cost and actual cost are given side by side. Though standard costing system will be useful for all types of commercial and industrial undertakings, it will be more useful in those undertakings where the production is standardized. Of course, the standard costing technique could be used where the production is not standardized, but application of such a technique in such a situation where the production is not standardized is a bit difficult. It doesn't mean that it cannot be used in the situations where production facility is not standardized, but it would be more useful and beneficial or easy to apply in situations where the business enterprises have established standardized production facility of something. Thanks for your time to watch this video. Keep supporting me so that I will be motivated to come out with many more videos through which I will share my expertise related to the subjects marketing, accounting, and financial management. I'll meet you in another video. Bye for now, everyone.